How to find out who is shorting a stock. We put out selections that we feel have a good chance of moving higher, but you also many short sale opportunities too. So for anyone who has ever wondered about selling short, this is going to be interesting to you. There are two sides to every coin, and there is a yes and a no in everyday life. The yin and yang: for every force there is a reaction, etc. Well, in the market there are two directions also. Up and down. For every stock you want to unload, there has to be someone on the other side who wants to buy it. It is an eternal tug of war that goes on, and it has been said the market is the great equalizer. That means that no matter how far out of whack something gets, the collective intelligence of the masses will bring it back into center. For the most part that is very true, and the reason that the market will never ever go straight up or straight down. Obviously either one would be an extreme, and the market rides those extremes. The fact is that stocks up and they go down, and to totally ignore 50% of the game is well silly. By now you all must realize that a stock's movement is influenced more by the overall market tone than its fundamentals on a day-to-day basis. By that we mean even the best of the best will pull back if the Nasdaq is tanking. So when we feel the market is ripe for a pullback, common sense should tell you it's time to get out of being long and get ready to go short. We won't personally take a long position in anything if we feel the overall market is heading south. Likewise, we won't short anything if we feel the trend is up. The old saying "you can't fight the tape" comes into play here, and it is as old as the 20s when they were using ticker tape machines. If the market is sliding, your stock probably is too. The next thing about shorting a stock is that we are in a whole different ballgame when it comes to what a company will do about sagging stock prices. Times have certainly changed, folks. Just a mere 10 years ago, stock prices were the furthest things from people's minds. But as the market became a national pastime, people started demanding answers from company CEOs. They wanted to know about the business end of things, and they wanted to know now. Then it didn't take long for lawyers to see a whole new revenue stream. When a company's share price starts to fall, get a group of people together and sue them. A classic class action suit. So companies responded to the new pressure by doing everything they could do to bolster up their share price, and that led to some interesting developments. Let's say your company is going to miss earnings this quarter. What better time to announce a 2-for-1 split and hope the excitement of the split hikes the disappointing numbers? Or suppose your stock price is simply sagging for lack of recent developments? Why not do a series of releases telling about the new China contracts? See the point? We are in a market where information is instantaneous and reactions to it can be severe. To wrap this up for today, remember we do indeed go short at times, but we don't put a lot of research into specific companies to find them. When we feel the market is going to pull back, we simply look at who was weak when it was moving up, because they will fall more when it's falling. Then we look at the real high flyers, because the ones that run up the fastest fall the fastest when the market goes sour. But more importantly than any of that is we do not like to hold short sales for more than a couple days. Along with the chance the market will bounce and take them back up, the company itself will be trying to turn things around too. The only time it's wise to hold a short sale is after a huge sustained run up in an average. For instance, if the Nasdaq went from 1,500 to 3,000 when the selling finally hits, it is probable it will last for a while and you could hold onto a short sale. Other than that though, very short-term short sales are your best bet.